huge implications for the government and, as you said, the country. Having insisted yesterday that she would stand firm, the Prime Minister and her Chancellor are expected to decide to announce that they are not proceeding with that decision to abolish the top rate of tax.
I was asked to look at whole, like, dozens and dozens
did
of different ideas.
Did you or did you not present them
gonna,
with a
I'm
paper
not gonna, I'm
suggesting
not gonna go,
this was a good idea?
I'm not going to go into the details of what ideas were or were not discussed by cabinet.
Why not?
Because those are private conversations, Kay. And what I'm interested in talking
it
about is the growth
the country,
plan that's going to see wages
servant.
Rising.
Was it your idea?
I would not describe it as my idea, no. We discussed lots and lots of different ideas. Okay, I think I've said as much as I want to say about this. Lots and lots of different ideas were discussed
sure
by lots
case,
and lots of different people.
I'm sure that's the case, but nevertheless, it's my job to press you on it. And my question is, as part of a paper, as part of a work, as part of a body of work that was given to them during the election campaign, did you suggest in writing that this could be a good idea?
I'm not going to go any further into private discussions that were held over the summer. I've said as much as I want to say about this. You know, there were widespread discussions involving me, involving other people, involving dozens of different ideas.
It was your idea, wasn't it?
I wouldn't describe it as my idea, no.
Whose idea was it?
I've already said that a lot of different ideas got discussed by a lot of different people.
Do you think that people should own their mistakes?
Look, I think this government is one that, like any government, is one that should listen. Listen to our democracy, we should listen to the public. We're a parliamentary democracy, so we should listen to MPs.
Let's come back to the point. Do you think, I'm sure my viewers will want to know, do you think that politicians should own their mistakes?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, the
yes
Chancellor's been
no?
going on TV, on other TV programmes this morning. Well, yes, of course politicians should be responsible, and
but you're
I think
not
that's what you're
mistake,
seeing today.
You're not owning your mistake, are you?
Well, no, I mean, I don't think that's accurate or fair, to be quite honest.
Why?
I don't accept your characterisation.
OK, so you didn't put anything in writing at all that said that this was a good idea? Because obviously, if there's a bit of paper saying that, that's going to come to light at some stage. Now's your opportunity to say whether you did or not.
I just told you I analysed a whole different idea, a number of ideas.
And was
I
was one asked of them to cutting the top rate of tax? Was one of
I'm
them
gonna,
cutting
I'm
the
not going to get into
it's
what all of those...
It's a straightforward question, Mr.
Philp.
I'm giving you the
were.
Opportunity to own your mistake. When did you realise it was a bad idea?
Well, I think the economics of it, there's a very strong case for doing it. As I've been saying on your programme, I don't think you were presenting that day, but, you know, there's, for reasons of international competitiveness, there is a strong economic case, but it's become very clear over the last few days that the public and parliamentary opinion don't like the idea for a variety of reasons. And so we've responded to that because we are a government that listens. And that's, I think, a good thing.
And it is come and talk, talk to the middle and come and talk to the listening bank.